Hi guys, welcome back to my video. For today's video, I'm doing another TJ Maxx find. I did go into another TJ Maxx. I just couldn't help myself. Plus, I had to pick up a couple of things for the household because we did update our bathroom. But anyways, without further ado, if you guys are interested in watching my mini TJ Maxx haul, make sure you hit the like button, make sure you subscribe, and let's get on to it. Alright, so I found a little bit of everything. I found some beauty products. I found some skincare, and I also found some nail products, so I'm gonna go ahead and talk about that. I think we'll start with skincare. So the first thing that I found was this Humphreys Witch Hazel Astringent 100% natural witch hazel. It says it's gentle, soothing, and non-drying. I actually currently use the Dickinson's one from, I usually purchase it at Walgreens, but I am almost done with it. This is the one that I currently use, but I'm almost done with it, so I figured I'd purchase this one. This one retails around $12 to $13 at some Target. It's a little bit more expensive. So I did find this for $6.99, which is a really good find in my opinion. I go through witch hazel really, really fast. It's usually my second product, like after I wash my face. I first cleanse, then I double cleanse, then I use this to go again to remove any excess makeup around my chin or ear area or like close to my hairline. So I use that. So that's really nice to find. I also found some like more like bath stuff. So I actually went on their website. This is the Castelbel Porto Relax Lavender Chamomile Fragrance Soap. This is the beautiful packaging it comes in. This retails for $3.99. So I went on their website and I was looking at some of their soaps and they go pretty high up in price. This is what the soap looks like. It's really pretty. It has like it smells delicious. It smells so good. But yeah, it basically has the logo of like the imprint of the brand. And I like to use these in the bath. Personally, sometimes I just use them, you know, to get some suds and my skin. I just like my skin feeling really moisturized. And from the feel of the soap bar, I can tell it's going to be really moisturizing. Sometimes you guys have to look at some of your soaps nearby and see, or some of your TJ Maxx, like more like kind of like soapy stuff, because I think that they are pretty good, especially like if I use some kind of like a bar soap. I do like this one so much, and you get a lot. You get 300 grams, so I think that's gonna be lasting you a while. This one is really nice. Again, I just think it's so good, and these are made in Portugal, so it's also an imported product. Really nice in my opinion. I think that's a really good find. I also found a Live Green exfoliating foot sponge, and I know they sell these at Ulta. This was retailing for $3.99. Originally is like $5 to $6, sometimes $8. So basically it's for your feet. Exfoliates rough skin and leaving your happy, healthy feet. I like to use this. I also use like a Revlon, I forget what those are called, but they basically like shave your foot down. Like it sounds weird, but it just helps your feet be smoother. Help your feet be, sorry, ESL moment. It helps your feet feel smoother. So this also, I thought would be really nice. I know that a lot of people use those Conjac sponges that are also really nice for your skin. So I purchased that. We're going to start getting into makeup, but one more thing I picked up. I picked another one of these Milk Makeup lip balms. I actually have the one that I picked up in my last haul in my purse. It's living in my purse. So the one that I have is the one in Nug. I picked up this one in Canatonic, which is more like a pinky shade. So this is the packaging for the Milk Makeup one. I just think it's really, really pretty. It is magnetic. Same thing with the other one. Again, the other one's now living in my purse. Like I mentioned in that video, that's what probably would have happened. I just think these are really moisturizing. They're really nice for the skin. This one doesn't have as much of a tinge as the other one does. The other one's like a more brownie tinge. But this is just really pretty for like after I do my skincare and I want to, you know, just relax, I put it on my lips. So just for an everyday thing, I think I will go through these really quick. And these are retailing for $5.99. And the original retail for like $8 to $10 on the Sephora website. So I picked up another one. I couldn't help myself. I tried to look for the foundation to see if I would find it in stores, but I didn't. And then I picked up a couple of more higher end products, which I was really excited about. I'm so happy that I found these. But really quickly, I want to talk about nails because I do my nails a lot. Like I wear these Impress press-ons a lot. The ones that I actually currently have on are these from the Kiss press-on manicure, the new ones. These are the ones that I have on currently. These last a pretty long time with well taken care of. I would suggest if you wear these kinds of nails, you put them on the night before and don't wash your hands. Like try not to wash your hands. They will last pretty long. So it comes basically with like an alcohol wipe and you clean your hands and then you stick them onto your nail beds. I think they're really nice. So I picked up these two. I found these at TJ Maxx and they retail for $3.99. Normally these retail for around $5 to $7, sometimes a little bit more, depending on kind of, because I know there's some more like couture ones. But I found these for $3.99. I really love this set. It's just so pretty. I'm thinking, hopefully it's not so blinding, but it has like little, sorry if it's really blinding. It has like little sparkles. It's just super pretty. And then my husband picked out these gray ones that have like a little etching here. It's really pretty as well. But for $3.99, I just thought that was a really good steal. So I picked those up, which I have a lot of. Like, I have a lot of these. Like, it's kind of crazy how many I have. I have a drawer full of all kinds of Impress press-ons. So those will live there. And I was really happy that I found those. All right, moving on. The number one thing that I found that I was super, super excited for. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Loose Glitter Kit. I've always wanted to try loose glitters. I was kind of scared and hesitant at first. So this is what the box looks like. It's very shiny and very iridescent. It's just really pretty. So it comes with 5 glitters and a glitter adhesive, which I've never tried, so I'm excited to try these. And these are Snowfall, Glisten, Frosted, Mistletoe, and Jolly. So they all look kind of white, but it says on the packaging that when applied, iridescent glitters appear certain colors. So like, for example, here is some of the colors. Like, they have like a lavender, they have a blue, kind of like a periwinkle blue. They have a more purpley kind of frosted color. They have a mistletoe green color, and they have a jolly, like a kind of like a peach pink color, which I'm so excited again, like I said, to try. And I'm really happy. I found this on sale for $7, and they had multiples of these. I kind of was like tempted. My husband was like, no, you only need one. I kind of wanted to purchase 2 or 3. By the way, my husband did purchase all these things for me, so thank you, honey, if you're watching my video. He did buy all these things for me. He almost mostly just buys whatever I want, which I mean, I buy whatever I want, but he pretty much spoils me. So I got these, like I said, on sale for $7. I don't even know what the price was. It doesn't even show. These retailed for $19.99 at the TJ Maxx store, and I got it for $7 on sale. So I'm really excited. These are really pretty. They look really nice. So they're like really pretty packaging. They have like obviously the holiday packaging, and it says Anastasia Beverly Hills. This one is the one in Jolly, which I believe is that pinky one. Yeah, let me just see if I can swatch it. I don't want to make a mess. Oh, they look really pretty. Oh, and they have a stopper. Oh my gosh. Look at that color. They're obviously very glittery, and they'll probably show up more with glitter glue, but oh my god, I'm so excited. Okay, I am excited to play with these and do like more beautiful, colorful looks. And I'm really excited because I pulled out my Anastasia Beverly Hills glow kit. Now that I switched kind of like my palettes around, and I'm really excited to work with the Dream Glow Kit, which is actually I have a little bit of this shade on my cheek, and they're so super pretty and super iridescent. So I'm pretty sure I'll be doing a lot of looks with these shades in the springtime. Ooh, I'm excited for spring. You guys cannot imagine how excited I am for to switch my makeup around and be excited for spring stuff. So yeah, I'm really excited for that. I'm really excited that I got this for $7. And this glitter adhesive alone, it's pretty expensive, to be honest. So this is the glitter adhesive from Anastasia Beverly Hills. So yeah, I'm excited for that. It's really pretty. 2 last things that I got at the TJ Maxx. These are primers, and I was really shocked when I saw these, because one, I've been really dying to try, and one I had tried a long time ago and I really liked it, but I never repurchased it. This is the Urban Decay Optical Illusion Complexion Primer. It's smoothing, rosehip, and argan oil, and pore perfecting. Like I said, $6.99 for this whole entire primer. I know these are more expensive. So, you guys, I just thought this was such a steal. It's unopened. I checked it. Like, nobody touched it. Nobody opened it, which I was really excited about. It's a full-size product for $6.99 when you guys can go to freaking Ulta and get this one for more, like, more expensive. So, I'm really happy that I found that one. And one that I've been dying to try, but I never brought myself to purchase it at full price. This is the Cover Effect Gripping Primer with Firming. So this is the most talked about gripping primer. Now, I know it was sold out for a while. When it first came out, I was sold out for a while and I really wanted it. This is the Cover Effect Gripping Primer base. So basically it's like a grip, it's meant to be gripping. It says a unique jelly texture that creates a smooth glass-like finish on the skin and grips makeup for long wear, flawlessness application, perfect for all skin types. It's vegan, free of parabens, gluten, mineral oil, fragrance, talc, sulfates, and phthalates, which is sounds, oh my god, my stomach, sounds really good in my book. So I was really excited to try this one. It's unopened, so I'm excited to pull that out and try it. Hopefully my next Shop My Stash, because I'm still working through my products, which I've been loving. So yeah, that's what both things that I found at my TJ Maxx. So yeah, I'm really excited. I think you guys, and they have a lot of like milk makeup, you guys. They have a lot of milk makeup. They have a lot of Anastasia Beverly Hills. I saw a lot of this brand, Kiko Milano. They also had, you know what? I think in the future, if I do these videos again, I think I'm going to try to record what I see in the store. Because I know somebody that I watch, Leah Janae. I'm sorry if I'm saying her name wrong. Leah Janae, she's the YouTuber here as well in the platform. She is obviously way bigger than I am. But she does these like TJ Maxx, Nordstrom hauls, and she shows like what she sees in the store. I was just kind of scared to like bring my phone out and start recording and talking because I feel kind of weird. Plus right now with everything going on, I think there's a lot of people around and I don't really want to be like recording while people are looking at me. It's kind of weird. But anyways, I'm going to try in the future if I do these videos again, which I probably will, because I'm so excited to find like really affordable things that are higher end. I'm probably gonna be recording into the in the stores and stuff, hopefully without getting in trouble. So yeah, if that's something you guys are interested in the future, let me know. I'm really excited to find a lot of these things. Again, with the glitters, these are pretty pricey. I think one glitter alone is like $20-something on the Anastasia Beverly Hills website. So I was really excited to find these products. If you guys are interested in, make sure you subscribe, make sure you hit the like button, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.